हेलो भाई और उनके बहनों, आई होप आप सब खुश है, सेफ है। नाउ टुडे आई एम विद IRC 66 1976 वर्जन पार्ट टू। इन द पार्ट फर्स्ट वी आर टॉक्ट अबाउट द सेफ स्टॉपिंग डिस्टेंस एंड ओवरटेकिंग साइड डिस्टेंस एंड द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द IRC विल बी कवर्ड इन दिस वीडियो। सो इफ यू हैवंट वॉच द प्रीवियस पार्ट, आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू गो एंड प्लीज वॉच द IRC 66 पार्ट वन वीडियो। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दिस वीडियो। हमने लास्ट वीडियो में देखा था कि जहाँ पे हम ओवरटेकिंग साइड डिस्टेंस ना दे पाए वहाँ पे हम इंटरमीडिएट साइड डिस्टेंस दे। जो भी एप्लीकेशन हमने 3.3.2 और 3.3.3 में देखे थे वही यहाँ पे भी अप्लाई हो गए। और क्राइटेरिया ऑफ मेजरमेंट वही सेम रहेगा कि 1.2 मीटर अबो द कैरेज वे हम डिस्टेंस मेजर करेंगे। नाउ लेट्स मूव टू द पॉइंट नंबर 5 विच टॉक्स अबाउट द हेडलाइट साइड डिस्टेंस एट द वैली कर्व। So in point 5.1 they have said that during daytime visibility is hardly a problem, but during night travel the design must be ensured that the roadway ahead is illuminated by vehicle headlights for a sufficient length. So what is the sufficient length? So the sufficient length will be equal to the safe side distance. तो वही जो हम दिन में जो safe side distance है वही हम headlight side distance as a night में consider करते हैं। तो 5.1 एक हम फिगर के द्वारा समझेंगे। सो आई विल ड्रॉ अ फिगर। सो हियर इज द फिगर। बेसिकली दिस इज द वैली कर्व एज यू ऑल नो। अज्यूम दैट दिस देयर इज अ व्हीकल व्हिच इज क्रॉसिंग द वैली कर्व एंड इन द लाइट ग्रीन कलर दिस इज द हेडलाइट बीम विथ द डिफ्लेक्शन एंगल। सो एंड दिस इज द ऑब्जेक्ट। So what they have said that the distance of headlight beam from a vehicle should be such that the driver must visible the object which is present at the safe side distance so that driver can apply the brake within the time and the vehicle must be stopped just before hitting the obstacle. So this was mentioned in the point 5.1. So let's move to the point 5.2. Now 5.2 talks about the criteria for the measurement. So what are the criteria we will see one by one. The height of headlight above the road surface is 0.75 meter. The useful beam of headlight is 1 degree upward from the grade of road and the height of object is nil. So we'll see this in figure. Okay, the first criteria tells that okay, suppose this is the headlight. So the distance of headlight from the road, what they have given is this is value is 0.75 meter. Okay. And the next criteria tells that this angle of deflection is 1 degree and the third point says that the height of this object is nil, means the height of object is zero. So these were the three criteria that were specified by the IRC. If suppose जैसे आप देख रहे हो यहाँ पे कि ये एक लेन है and we consider this as the two up lanes. So that the vehicles are moving in this direction and these are the two lanes in which the vehicles are moving downwards. So this is the median. So यहाँ पे हमें क्यों जरूरत नहीं है। तो if suppose one vehicle is moving in this lane and the other vehicle want to overtake this, so it can obviously shift to this lane and maneuver to this and again come back to this lane. So there is no special distance that is provided for the overtaking. Already there are two lanes and two lanes will be sufficient for overtaking process. So that's why there is no special provision for the overtaking side distance required for the highways with four or more than four lanes. So this was given in the point 6.1. So let's talk about the side distance on horizontal curve. तो ये भी एक critical thing है कि अब अगर हम horizontal curve में जा रहे हैं तो side distance एक बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर होता है। इफ सपोज यहाँ पे कोई प्रॉपर्टी है, कोई भी बिल्डिंग बनी हुई है और अब यहाँ से जा रहे हैं तो हमें यहाँ से आते हुए व्हीकल दिखे तो ये जो भी हमारा व्यू ब्लॉक होगा तो इस व्यू को कंसिडरेशन में रखते हुए इस पॉइंट में इन्होंने कुछ गाइडलाइंस बताए हैं। सो लेट्स मूव अहेड टू पॉइंट नंबर 7। सो इन 7.1 दे हैव मेंशन लाइक लैक ऑफ विजिबिलिटीज ड्यू टू द लैक ऑफ विजिबिलिटीज इन लैटरल डायरेक्शन में be caused due to the walls, cut slopes, buildings, etc. and the straightforward manner of achieving the necessary setback in situation is to remove the obstruction. तो यहाँ पे इन्होंने क्या mention किया है कि जो भी यहाँ पे बिल्डिंग और जो भी ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन रहेगा, तो एक तरीका क्या है कि हम उस ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन को रिमूव कर देंगे, बट दिस इज नॉट ऑलवेज पॉसिबल. इन सच इन सम केसेस यू कैन नॉट रिमूव दिस ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. सो वॉट थिंग वी शुड डू, वी शुड डिजाइन इन सच अ वे दैट वी शुड नॉट हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम फॉर द साइड डिस्टेंस एट द कर्व. सो कुछ सेटबैक डिस्टेंस के बारे में इन्होंने कहा है कि सेटबैक डिस्टेंस मतलब जो भी डिस्टेंस रोड के सेंटर से जो भी प्रॉपर्टी लाइन या फिर जो भी ऑब्स्टेकल है उस ऑब्स्टेकल के लाइन में जो भी आएगा, तो इस टोटल डिस्टेंस को इन्होंने सेटबैक डिस्टेंस ऐसे कहा है. सो लेट्स सी हाउ इट इज कैलकुलेटेड. सो हियर दे हैव गिवन सम फॉर्मूला सो दैट द सेटबैक मिनिमम सेटबैक विल बी कैलकुलेटेड. हियर ऑल द टर्मिनोलॉजीज मेंशन इन द फॉर्मूलाज हैव बीन मेंशन हियर. सो एम इज द सेटबैक, आर इज द रेडियस ऑफ द रेडियस एट द सेंटर लाइन ऑफ द कर्व, एन इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द सेंटर लाइन ऑफ रोड एंड द सेंटर लाइन ऑफ इन साइड लाइन इन मीटर, एंड एस इज द साइड डिस्टेंस. सो वी विल सी वन बाय वन वॉट इज द एम एन ऑल दिस टर्म. सो आई विल शो दिस थिंग इन फिगर. सो दिस रेड वन विल बी द सेंटर लाइन ऑफ रोड, ओके. दिस ग्रीन विल बी द सेंटर लाइन ऑफ इंटरनल लेंथ. सो वॉट दे आर मेंशन इज वॉट इज द एम. एम इज द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द सेंटर लाइन ऑफ रोड टू द पॉइंट वेयर द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन हैज इट्स एक्सटर्नमोस्ट पॉइंट, ओके. एंड वॉट इज एन. एन इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द सेंटर लाइन ऑफ दिस इंटरनल लेन टू द सेंटर लाइन ऑफ होल रोड, ओके. आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड एवरीथिंग. जो भी ये इसके कैलकुलेशन से डेफिनेशन से ये आपको किसी भी वीडियो में जो भी गेट की प्रिपरेशन की वीडियो से या फिर यूपीएससी टेक्निकल के वीडियोज है आप यहाँ पे देख सकते हो. वहाँ पे वो लोगों ने अच्छे से डिस्कस किया हुआ होगा. मैं सिर्फ यहाँ पे आपको आईएससी में क्या क्या दिया वो मैं बता रहा हूँ. सो हियर दे हैव मेंशन अ पॉइंट इन 7.3 दैट व्हाट एवर द डिस्टेंस दैट वी विल बी गेटिंग फ्रॉम दिस डिस्टेंस दे हैव एक्चुअली प्लॉटेड इन द ग्राफ एज शोन हियर. एंड दे हैव ऑल्सो मेंशन दैट द डिस्टेंस दैट विल बी कैलकुलेटेड यूजिंग द अबव फॉर्मूला विल बी समवट लेस as compared to graph, and if you refer to the graph we will get the values to the higher side which would be more safer, but definitely you can take both of the things for the designing. So let's see what's there in the graph. So we are at the graph. So in the graph what they have mentioned is the speed. For each speed they have the different curve. So in the x axis they have mentioned the radius of horizontal curve at the center line specially, and at the vertical axis they have mentioned the setback distance, that is the m value. So we know the radius of curve, we know the speed, we know the what is s. S is the safe stopping side distance, okay. So we know v, we know s, we know r. So by knowing the three things we will calculate the m value from this graph. So for this purpose this graph has been made. So let's move ahead. Okay, let's move to the point 7.4. So whatever the lateral clearance that we have discussed where was for the side distance, the safe side distance. So they have mentioned that similarly if we change the stopping side distance with the overtaking side distance, we can definitely calculate the lateral clearance for the overtaking and intermediate side distance also. But the value that we will be getting for this overtaking and intermediate will be large and will not be economically feasible except for the flat curve. So this was mentioned in 7.4. This point you can have a more clarification when you see a gate lecture or any technical lecture. So this point will be more clear to you in that videos. So let's move to the 7.5. So whatever they have mentioned in point 7.5, I will discuss with a figure with you. So now let's discuss the point 7.5 with the help of figure. So here this is the plan and this is the cross section of road. So here the vehicle A has to be moved here and B wants to go here. So there should be a side distance so that they can see each other, but there might be chances like there is a slopy, there is a hill section on the right side of the curve, okay, as mentioned in the shaded portion. So to what level, okay, in cross section you can see to what level this should be cut down so that for the person with A should clearly see that there is an obstacle or a vehicle at point B. So what this code say that this value up to which the slope should be कट डाउन इज 0.7 मीटर. सो हाउ दिस वैल्यू 0.7 मीटर कम्स? सो दे हैव सेड दैट फॉर द सेफ सेफ साइड डिस्टेंस वी हैव सीन दैट द ड्राइवर्स आई लेवल विल बी एट 1.2 मीटर्स एंड द ऑब्जेक्ट विल बी एट 0.15 मीटर्स. ओके, सो विल टेक द एवरेज ऑफ दिस टू. सो इट्स एवरेज कम्स टू बी अराउंड 0.7 मीटर्स. सो दे हैव सेड दैट इफ एनी स्लोप इज प्रेजेंट एट द इनसाइड एज ऑफ द हॉरिजॉन्टल कर्व देन दैट स्लोप शुड बी कट डाउन टिल द लेवल 0.75 मीटर फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड सो दैट द पर्सन एट ए शुड क्लियरली विजिबल इफ देर एनी ऑब्स्टेकल एट बी. सो दिस वॉज मेन्शन इन 0.7.5. सिमिलरली इफ यू वॉन्ट टू प्रोवाइड द ओवरटेकिंग साइड डिस्टेंस एट दिस पॉइंट सो वी शुड डू एज यू कैन रिकलेक्ट दैट वी वेर हैविंग 1.2 मीटर्स फॉर द ए एज वेल एज बी वाइल ओवरटेकिंग. So here the average of both 1.2 plus 1.2 divided by 2 will be 1.2. So if we want to have a overtaking side distance, so the level to which the slope will be cut, it should be 1.2 meters. So this was mentioned in 0.7.5. I hope you understood everything that I have talked. We have covered this 7.5 in the diagrammatical form. So let's move to the 7.6. So what does this point say is where horizontal and summit curve overlap, the line of sight will not be over the top of crest but to the one side and in part may be off the roadway. So the design in such cases should be provided for the required side distance for the both vertical as well as horizontal. So what they want to say is if suppose a horizontal curve and summit curve are happens to at the same site location, so for the site distance, so we have to design for the both type of site distance, one for the horizontal and another for the vertical curve. So this was about the 0.7.6. To be precise, if the horizontal curve was there, we used to have a line of sight in the cross direction, and if a summit curve was there, then our line of sight will be like this. We have to together deal with both the things. We have to fix our line of sight that should be clear for the safe side distance. So this was in the 0.7.6. So now let's talk about the 0.8, which talks about measuring and recording side distances graphically. Combinedly, this 8 point wants to tell that whatever we have discussed in the criteria of measurement in each of the case. In the side distance, safe side distance, what we have discussed was the driver eye height was at the 1.2 meters and the object height was 0.15 meter. Similarly, for the oversight distance, vehicles were having the height of 1.2 meter like this. This only criteria they have mentioned separately in the point number 8. So there is not much to talk about this. So in 8.4 they tell that if suppose at a particular location there happens to we have to deal with the two type of side distance, one is horizontal and another is vertical, so whichever is smaller should be recorded on the plan, that is the L section drawing. So this was the thing that they have specially mentioned in 8.4. So now let's move to the next point, that is point number 9, which talks about the side distances at the intersection. So we will cover this in brief. So the first, they have divided the intersections, aggregate intersections particularly, in two types. One is uncontrolled and second is priority. So with the help of figure, we'll try to understand what is this. So if suppose this is an intersection, this is the road A and this is the road B. So what is the uncontrolled intersection? The uncontrolled intersections are the intersections where both A and B, both road are of same category. So what does that mean? Both road are of type NH or SH. That means same. So there is no priority. We have to give the equal importance for the traffic from the both of the roads. So this was about the uncontrolled one. So in the priority one, so in priority intersections, there will be one major road and another will be the minor. If suppose A is the major and B is the minor, then what we have to do? We have to give a sign for the minor road so that we will be giving the priority for the A road users rather to the B. So this was about the priority intersections. So we'll discuss the side distances for each of them respectively. So first we will talk about the uncontrolled intersections. So in uncontrolled intersections, whatever point they have mentioned, we'll try to discuss with the help of figure which is given in the code itself. So let's see what they have mentioned in 9.2.1, 9.2.2 as well as 9.2.3 in the drawing itself. So let's assume that this is the road A and this is the road B, एज इट इज अनकंट्रोल्ड इंटरसेक्शन, दैट मीन्स ए एंड बी आर ऑफ सेम कैटेगरी. ओके, नाउ यू कैन सी वन व्हीकल इज कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस डायरेक्शन एंड अदर इज कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस डायरेक्शन. सो दिस इज द लाइन ऑफ साइट विच मस्ट बी क्लियर सो दैट दे शुड हैव इनफ टाइम टू स्टॉप एट द इंटरसेक्शन. दैट मीन्स बिफोर रीचिंग टू दिस पॉइंट दे शुड स्टॉप, दे शुड कम टू हॉल्ट सो दैट द एक्सीडेंट शुड बी अवॉइडेड. ओके, सो वॉट शुड बी दिस डिस्टेंस? सो दिस डिस्टेंस शुड बी द एस एस डी फॉर द बी एंड दिस शुड बी द एस एस डी फॉर द व्हीकल विच कमिंग फ्रॉम ए. सो दिस डिस्टेंसेज शुड बी द एज पर द डिजाइन लिमिट्स फॉर ए एंड बी. सो दिस ट्राइंगल इज कॉल्ड एज मिनिमम साइड ट्राइंगल एट अनकंट्रोल्ड इंटरसेक्शन. नाउ वॉट दे आर मेन्शन इन 9.2.3. So they have said that if this line of sight is not cleared, if suppose there is one tree or any building which cannot be removed, okay, so in that case what should be the solution? So the solution is that here for any of these a speed limit sign should be placed so that SSD for particular arm will get reduced. And then what will happen due to this the minimum side triangle will reduce. Okay, now we'll have a clear side and due to the reduction of speed it will stop within this distance and it will stop within this distance. Okay, I hope I have cleared your doubt regarding the triangle. So now let's talk about the priority intersections. So we'll discuss with the help of a figure. So as I have discussed earlier, in priority one will be the major road, other will be the minor road. So the stopping set distance for the major road is directly given in this table. For the respective speed they have given the respective stopping set distance, while this 15 meter is constant for the minor road. So this was all about the priority intersection. There is not much things to discuss in this. So let's move to the next point in 9.3.2, what they have said. So what they have told that whatever the values they have mentioned in table 4 are taken corresponding to 8 second travel time. So they have used the value of t equals to 8 to calculate this value. This is what mentioned in this point. So I hope everything is cleared for this RC66. If any queries you have, you can put in comment. Thank you.